Hey everyone, Kayla Anders here. I am a licensed clinical professional counselor and life coach. I currently have a coaching program for individuals in the LGBTQIA+ community who are wanting to deepen their connection in their relationship and knows that in order to do that, they need to have open and honest communication while ditching any resentment and without it causing conflict. And today I wanted to follow up with you all regarding boundaries, right? So we came together on Monday evening this time to talk a little bit about what boundaries are. And specifically we spoke on the concept of time boundaries, right? Boundaries with our time and some ways to be able to go about doing that so that you can have more of what we say instead of work-life boundaries versus work-life balance, right? Because balance can be really hard to obtain and sometimes it's just so kind of ambiguous and sometimes it's really hard to know what balance really looks like. So being able to have boundaries so that they're clear and you have clear expectations and clear guidelines to be able to enjoy your life and be able to adapt to this really challenging year, right? This really challenging school year. And so I wanted to come live with you guys today and do kind of a Q&A, right? So for those of you that are watching now, hey Mackenzie, hey Megan, for those of you that are watching now, or if you watch on the replay, if there are any specific questions that you have about boundaries and how to implement them in your life, please comment below and post in the comments during the replay as well. And I will answer those because I want to make sure that you really understand what they're all about and how they're so helpful in all of our lives, in all areas of our lives. And so I had some questions, right, that I thought maybe you guys might already have in your mind. And I wanted to give you some tips and some suggestions on some specific ways in your current field on how to implement boundaries and when certain situations that you might be faced with when they come up or if they come up, how to address them, how to stick with your boundaries, how to communicate your boundaries in a way that works best for you. So the first question is how can you set boundaries, right? How can you set boundaries with a boss without getting in trouble, right? Because a lot of us, we don't want to get in trouble, right? We want to be able to be a great employee, want to do a great job, right? We don't want to cause any conflict. We don't want to ruffle any feathers. We want to be able to maintain our job, right? We don't want anything ultimately negative to come out of setting boundaries, right? Because boundaries are supposed to be helpful and positive and something that's needed and that's okay. Anna, how can I set healthy boundaries with work? Things feel expected. Yes. Yeah, we're going to get to that. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, so how can you do it without getting into trouble, right? And with things feeling expected of you, right? So an example I have, which I think it could go to both, is when you're not able to do something that's expected of you, let them know that you're not able, unable to, right? First of all, being direct about that, letting them know that you're not able to because of whatever situation or whatever reason, or maybe other work duties that you have, other responsibilities that you have, or maybe needing to just, you know, manage your time spent at work. And if that's not enough, depending on the situation, also if there is a way to provide a solution, right, of when you may be able to do if that's something that's asked of you, right? So just kind of breaking it down would be, so when you provide them with them a reason as to why you're saying no, basically, it gives them more insight into what you're going through, right? So if you let them know, I'm not able to do this because of that, then they know where you're coming from versus be like, no, I'm not able to do that. Well, that just leaves so much room for assumptions, and you know what they say about assuming, right? So yes, letting them know why you're not able to do it at that point in time or in general. And if it is something that maybe you are able to do at a later date or in a different way, providing solutions or suggestions to, you know, your boss, supervisor, and so it becomes more collaborative, right? And that gives them a strong message that it's not that you're just saying no, right? But you're willing and open to do what's needed, and if it's a realistic expectation, right? Or if it's not an unrealistic expectation, letting them know, you know, at this point in time, because of all these things going on, I wouldn't be able to do that with the amount of time that I have, and be able to have time set aside right outside of work to do that. But, you know, if there are solutions that you can come up with, can we come up with another solution or a way to be able to work around that or make the best of the time? Anna, that's a good idea to let them know why. Yes, letting them know why. Another question that I thought maybe you might have is, how can you set boundaries without creating conflict, right? A lot of us fear conflict. A lot of us are taught that it's something to avoid at all costs. I know that was me. And that's a big part of my coaching program, is that fear of conflict, that avoidance of conflict actually can cause the conflict to happen. So probably these things you've heard before too, right? Using I statements, I am not able to, right? I am not able to do this or that, is so important. It helps us to own our own stuff and be able to acknowledge I versus any you statements, because you equals defensiveness, right? We can put walls up automatically. And being really aware of your tone and your body language when you're speaking, right? When you're saying, when you're creating those boundaries. Whether that's in your work life, your personal life, anywhere, right? All these things can be applied to any area of your life. But yeah, really being aware of your body language and your tone, because you guys may already know this, your tone and your body language, your nonverbals, as we call them, right? Says so much more than what you're actually saying. And when you're in high stress situations, high pressure, it's already hard enough saying no, right? And a lot of times, maybe there's fear that you have underlying there. So there's some like intense emotions that you might be experiencing. Being really intentional and mindful about your tone and your body language, right? Because once again, that says a lot, doesn't it? It says so much. And if it's a point in time, like, I'm all about being realistic, right? If we have the opportunity to be like, you know what, I'm not in that mindset right now to where I can say this in a gentle, firm, confident tone, and I can have these, you know, proper body language. I think I'm going to give myself some time before I actually come to this person, establish these boundaries, or talk about it at a later date. Sorry. Let's see. Anna, it's hard to set boundaries at home with prioritizing time for me. This can lead to conflict sometimes. Absolutely. Yeah, what's the hardest part, Anna, about setting boundaries at home, like with prioritizing time for you? What's the hardest part that ends up leading to the conflict? And so I'll get back to that when you post that in the comments, and I'll keep moving forward. Hey, Mallory. And then the next question is, what are some easy ways to set boundaries for yourself, right? I am all about keeping things simple, keeping it simple, and practicing them, right? And so when it comes to boundaries, if we're not comfortable with doing it, maybe we've not known how to do it, or we've just, like I said, been uncomfortable. Start with a situation or a person where you're able to, you're like, yeah, I feel pretty comfortable doing this, right? So the least amount of discomfort in establishing a boundary. Maybe it's someone that you're fairly close with, you feel comfortable with, right? You have that trusting, comfortable relationship with. Start with someone like that and practicing boundaries with them. Because then once you're able to practice, right, and do it in situations where you feel most comfortable, then you can work your way up into the least, you know, the least comfortable, right? Or the most uncomfortable situations, because you've got that practice, you've got that momentum, you're building that confidence in being able to express your and communicate your boundaries. And then once it gets to those harder situations or those harder circumstances, you're much more confident in doing so. Yes, thank you. Yeah. Okay, so the next question is practice. So, like, what are some tips for reminding yourself of your boundaries you have already set? So, one of my favorite words is intention. It's a lot about being intentional and remembering why they're important to begin with, right? Remembering why they're important and really being intentional about that, right? Intentional about checking in with yourself, right? So let's say on Monday, we talked about a suggestion of setting up a schedule for ourselves. And so we know how much time we're spending at work and we know how much time, let's say, we're spending outside of work, right? So when you set up that schedule, you're able to keep track of those boundaries more. And doing it just check-ins with yourself, because boundaries can change, right? Boundaries need to be flexible. Maybe we're okay with something today, and maybe we're not okay with it tomorrow, depending on what's going on in our day, depending on how we're doing personally. So being really intentional about checking in with yourself and how you're doing and how you're feeling and how you're responding to situations, because that's really what it's all about is, am I okay? Is this okay for me now? Or is this not okay for me now? To know if it's something you can say yes to, or if it's something you need to say no to. So really getting into the practice of being intentional about checking in with yourself, because that is really your biggest, that's your compass, right? Your compass and being able to is really listening to you. And then when you listen to yourself, then you're able to know when a boundary needs to be put in place. Michael Felt, you're my guy. Get ready for some boundaries. Yes. Yes, Michael, right. Michael will be the one to practice with, right, Mallory? Yes. And I feel obligated to put the kids in front of my needs. It's hard to find that balance. I can get irritable and have an attitude. Yes, you said you feel obligated to put the kiddos in front of your needs. Okay, so when you feel that obligation and you end up maybe putting your kids' needs before your own, you say you end up getting irritable and have an attitude. So the longer that you continue to do that, right, and the longer you continue to get irritable and put them in front of you, ultimately in the long run, what do you think will happen? What would you think would continue to happen, or in the long run continue to happen with for yourself and maybe even with your relationship with your kids if you were to continue to do that? So it's a question I would have for you. And then another thing is just making sure, once again, your well-being is at the top of the priority list. I talk about that all the time. And that is what you're talking about, Anna, right? It's hard to do that. There can be guilt. There can be obligations. Maybe if it's even how we look at putting your kids in front of your needs, right? The word need is really, I'm really intentional about using the word need. Needs are called needs for a reason. And when we need something, it means that is what we need to be at our best for the people around us, right? And so if we are feeling obligated, maybe then the more that we do that, we're putting ourselves and our well-being on the back burner. And then eventually, and maybe that would happen for you, Anna, is exactly what I was going to say, is you'll burn out. Exactly, is burning out. And so then what will that be like, and how will you be showing up for your kids if you're burnt out, right? And I always say the littlest things make the biggest difference. So one, I'm going to call it small boundary. One small boundary. What boundary would you need to implement right now in your life so that you have energy, right? So that you are making your needs a top priority, and so that you aren't irritable, right? And that you can be really present with your kids and in a way that aligns with what's most important to you as a parent. Yes, needs are called needs for a reason. Yeah. Yeah. I like it too. All right. And so the last question is what do you do if someone is trying to push the boundaries you've already set? Right? Ooh, those are tough situations, right? And you've expressed it and you're like, yeah, I established these boundaries. This is great. This is awesome. I'm proud of myself for being able to communicate what's okay and what's not okay. But darn it, that person keeps trying to push them, right? That person keeps trying to push them. And what I found is I'll remind that person in a firm tone, right? We're talking about tone, right? And direct eye contact, and firm but gentle, right? Doesn't mean I'm being aggressive, I'm not being mean, or I'm not kind of sounding insecure and standoffish, but I'm being very firm with my tone. So I would say this is a firm tone that I'm giving you right now, a confident tone, and it's also gentle, right? I'm not coming across in a mean way to you right now. So I would remind them of my boundary. I would remind them of my boundary. And then if they just keep doing it, I will let them, I needed to change my boundaries with that person because they're not respecting them. So I need to do something different. I need to ask them to, if you're not able to respect this boundary, then I'm going to need to do this, right? Because this isn't okay. Like, let's say if somebody's yelling at you, right? You let them know, I will not continue this conversation if you continue to yell, because that's disrespectful to me. And the person keeps yelling, and you can let them know, however many times you feel like you need to. Maybe that's just one more time. I'm only going to let you know, remind you one more time of your boundary. And then if they continue, then you do what you need to do, ultimately. Giving yourself permission to do what you need to do, to be okay, to take care of yourself. Because you're communicating, right? You're direct about what you need. You're direct about what's okay and not okay. They're not respecting that. And that is their choice, right? They are making that choice not to respect your boundaries. And so they're going to probably continue to not respect it until something else happens, and depending on where that situation occurs, if it's professionally, depends on who it is, right? That might mean needing to go to someone else, a higher authority or something, and talking about that situation, because it will continue. And then if it continues, what will happen if it continues and that person continues to disrespect you? Yeah, Mallory, that happens to you. Yes. Yeah. And confidently to set the boundary. It's an empowering word. Yes. I love it. Yes. So any other questions that you guys, I don't know if I missed any here. Megan, you asked, what do we do when our boundaries we need to set hurt people in our life? So when I hear that question, what I really kind of hear from an outside perspective is, what do I do when I have a need and I'm expressing my need and it hurts someone else by making my well-being a top priority? That's kind of what I hear, right? We're not responsible for other people's responses or reactions to making our well-being a top priority or in general. And so how they're receiving it, if it hurts their feelings, then... it's going to happen, right? That's the reality of it. We don't hurt them, but it's how they interpret us putting those boundaries into place. And hey, I'm a hopeful person. So I'm like, well, maybe that's something that they needed to experience, is they needed to experience somebody. Maybe they have a hard time expressing their boundaries with people. And maybe they're not used to doing it themselves. And so when they see a boundary put in place, maybe it hurts their feelings. But ultimately, whatever the reason is we aren't responsible for other people's emotions and feelings. And the only thing that we can control, right, is taking care of ourselves and communicating and doing and making our well-being a top priority and standing up for ourselves. That is the only thing we can control. So, if we are more preoccupied with how other people feel when we stand up for ourselves or we establish those boundaries, we'll always feel walked all over. We'll always end up feeling resentful, exhausted, burnt out. And even if it's a personal relationship with someone, disconnected with them and not respected. So yeah. So I hope that answered your question. Let's see if I have anything else. It is so hard to do this, Anna, you said. I remember to be kind and know their reaction is about their issues, not mine. Absolutely. It totally is. Yes. I love that. That is so important. When we're doing what's ultimately best for us and taking care of us, however somebody else reacts, that has to do with them. That doesn't have to do with something negative about us, right? Or something wrong about us. Love that. All right, you guys, if you have any other questions, like I said, please, after you, if you watch this on the replay, or if anything comes to mind a later date, post in the comments below under this live, and I will be sure to answer them for you. And just want to say again, it has been such a privilege to be able to come live and talk with you today and on Monday about boundaries, because they're really, really important. They're really helpful. It's something that can be really hard to do, but it's something that is needed. And I just encourage you to keep making your well-being a top priority, because for you to be the best teacher, the best educator, whatever career you have, that you're the specialty that you're in this field, you got to take care of yourself first, right? And I've really done a lot of work on my own and my own individual self and my own journey and being able to do that. And because I really struggle to have boundaries myself. And the more that I give myself permission to do that, I am such a better coach, therapist, partner, sister, friend, you name it, because of it, because I am well, right? I am healthy because of it. You're welcome, Anna. I'm so glad it's been helpful. I will definitely put the group link at the bottom too in the comments if there's any of you that would like to join that. You are amazing too. Thank you. All right, you guys, enjoy the rest of your evening. Bye-bye.